श्री गौरी करुणा लहरी तो यजाक्षी शंकरेश्वरी।
नमस्कार ಮತ್ತು ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ದಸರಾ ಹಬ್ಬದ ಶುಭಾಶಯಗಳು. ಐ ಆಮ್ ಇಂದ್ರಾಕ್ಷಿ ದೇವಿ, ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಡಾಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೇಟ್ ಮಹಾರಾಜ ಆಫ್ ಮೈಸೂರ್ ಶ್ರೀ ಜಯಚಾಮರಾಜ ಒಡೆಯರ್. ದಸರಾ ಈಸ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಫೆಸ್ಟಿವಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮೈ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ವೆರಿ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಮೆಮರೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸೆಲೆಬ್ರೇಷನ್ ವೈಲ್ ಗ್ರೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಅಪ್. ದ ಮೈಸೂರ್ Palace and my father, the Maharaja, formed the central focus of all the celebration and rituals connected with Dasara festival in the city and the state of Mysore. That being said, he considered himself to be the representative of the people, and Dasara, he would say, was very much the people's festival. The palace and the city of Mysore adorned the festive look. The palace would be bustling with activities every evening, starting from the first till the ninth evening. A formal darbar would be conducted in the palace darbar hall. The palace was illuminated with thousands of bulbs. My sibling and I would get dressed early and join my father while he got dressed for the darbar and spent time with him while we could. My father would start the evening darbar festive by first going to the Atmavilas Ganesha temple within the palace premises to offer his prayers, after which he would go to the darbar hall and he would start by doing puja to the throne. My mother and my siblings and I would watch the whole darbar ceremony from the balcony overlooking the hall. Rose petals were showered on my father by the state elephant as he was on the throne. The state horse would follow and bow down to the throne. The hall would consist of Arzu noblemen, officials and other prominent citizens. Every evening during the 9 days of Dasara, there used to be a Sangeeta performance during the Darbar, a specially created open platform like a lift would make the artist come up in front of the throne and ground below. The stalwarts of classical music from all over India would come and perform. It was magical and a treat to listen. Also be some form of entertainment planned every evening and we would enjoy the program. As children, we also loved listening to the Mysore English Band. We would write down a list of songs and send them to the bandmaster. Some of our favorite requests were Colonel Bogey, Stars and Stripes Forever. And this practice continued till my brother was alive. As kids, we loved running around the darbar hall. My father would come up to a private gathering for the Pada Puja, which was performed by my mother. After the Pada Puja, he would always give us the flowers that he wore around his wrist. We would end the day by having dinner with him every evening. We looked forward to dinner as he would discuss the happenings of the day. As kids, we looked forward to the last 2 days of Dasara, the most Ayodh Puja and Vijaya Dashmi. On Ayodh Puja day, my father would perform puja and worship the royal arms and emblems as well as various means of transport like elephant, horses, cars, silver chariot and palanquin, etc. It was a grand affair on Vijaya Dashmi day. After praying to the arms for the second time, he would cut a white pumpkin with the royal sword. Once the pumpkin was cut, the jetis would perform the Vajra Mushti Kalga. The jetis wrestlers would fight with the metal knuckle duster until they drew blood. The first to draw blood would be declared as a winner. The wrestling match created a great sense of excitement amongst us. Jetis would come from all over Karnataka, and it was a privilege for them to perform at the palace on Vijaya Dashmi. After lunch, about 3 p.m., my father would leave to Bani Mantap for the worship of the Bani tree, which was located on the northeast end of the city. He would sit in the golden howdah on the top of the Ambari elephant and went to the Bani Mantap in a splendid procession that slowly wound its way through the streets of Mysore. He would reach Bani Mantap only by 6 or so. As the mile long procession moved ahead slowly, a distance of 4 kilometers took 3 to 4 hours. People along the way would stop to greet him and give him flowers and fruits. The offerings were placed on a silver plates and lifted up on a silver poles for him to touch and symbolically accepted. My brother would accompany him on the procession in the howdah. After the day's festive at the Bani Mantapa, my father would inspect a torchlight parade. The torchlight parade would start at around 7 p.m. Torches were turned on and my father astride a horse would take the guard of honor. Thereafter, a return procession back to the palace would begin. My father, again sitting on the golden howdah, would return along the same route. As by this time city was illuminated along the route, the sight was something that you can never see again. On the last 2 days of Dasara, the Arsus community would join us for the lunch. When I look back today, it is all seems like a fairy tale, and I feel privileged and blessed to have been able to witness and partake in the grand spectacle that Mysore Dasara was. Thank you for listening to my reminiscences of my childhood as I grew up in the palace. I pray to Goddess Chamundeshwari to put an end to the hard times we are all going through and bless us. Stay safe. Take care.